Welcome back to our fall protection inspection series. Every piece of your fall protection equipment is critical. If one piece fails, then they all fail. In today's episode, we'll look at SRLs and lanyards. Both self-retracting lifelines and lanyards are critical pieces of equipment that keep you from plummeting to the ground in the case of a fall. By the end of this video, you'll understand how to perform an inspection on both and have a complete understanding on what the removal criteria looks like that would cause an SRL or lanyard to be pulled from service. My name is Ben, and this is the Lifting and Rigging Channel. We're back with Tom Horner, Inspection Manager at Mazzella, to learn how to properly perform inspections on SRLs and lanyards. Before getting in the air or tying off, you need to inspect these items and make sure they are safe for use. Tom will walk us through how to do just that and show us some examples of criteria that should stop you from using an SRL or lanyard and cause you to pull it from service. So, let's get into it.
You're gonna have your initial, which is when you receive it in from your vendor. Make sure it is what you ordered, the model number, and that it was obviously right for your application. Your next type is gonna be your frequent, which is gonna be your daily operational, who's ever utilizing the lanyard or SRL. The person is gonna pick up their harness, they're gonna pick up their lanyard, they're gonna pick up their SRL retractable. Do that inspection, make sure everything is in proper working order before they put it all together and go use it as a system out in the field. Lastly, we're going to do the periodic inspection, which is once every 12 months, not to exceed. This is the documented inspection for each item. You're going to document the manufacturer, the model, the serial number, the length, the type of unit it is it a synthetic or a wire rope, and then the location, which is generally the person it's assigned to and or the department. We can absolutely help you with your SRL lanyard inspections and even repairs. We do put all of our inspectors through proper training. We have that paper trail so that when you select us to perform your inspections as a third party, we have that defendable position. There are certain SRLs that can be sent back to the manufacturer for repair. It depends on the size and the model number, but nearly all of the manufacturers do have a program in place where they can take apart the SRL, replace the internals, test it and recertify it, and ship it back. When it comes to the lanyards themselves, those are going to be considered consumable and disposable. You're going to refer to your industry via OSHA requirements for that industry, and then also ANSI Z359, the manufacturer's recommendation, and also your own internal corporate requirements. You definitely want to go to a fall protection specialist, somebody who lives in this field all day every day, because they need to assist you with the proper selection based on your needs, how to size them, how to do the math to figure out to make sure that you're putting all the right pieces together for your system, which is something that we do at Mazzella, and we partner with a number of very professional companies to assist us with. Anytime you're inspecting your personal fall protection, your harness, your lanyard, your SRO retractable, your first failure item is the immediate end of that inspection. That is enough to remove it from service at that point, document it as such, and move on to your next piece of equipment. You absolutely want to have the clear identification, the markings completely legible. You have to know what you're working with. And then you're going to look for all the normal physical defects. Make sure something hasn't been modified or repaired in the field. Make sure all the original hardware is in place. Make sure all the hardware isn't, there's no deformation, no heat damage. Make sure that your webbing doesn't have any cuts, tears, heat damage, weld splatter, UV damage, chemical damage. Make sure that all of the pieces are moving freely as such, and that the braking system is in perfect working shape. I'm going to walk you through the visual inspection of an SRL self-retracting lifeline. What we have here is a nylon version. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the identification from the manufacturer to make sure we have complete legibility. I can see the manufacturer, got the manufacturer's date, got the model number, got the length, very important, got the serial number for traceability, the type of material, your arrest force, your arrest distance, and all the other information on the identification is legible. Make sure all of the hardware is original to the item and in place. So I see that and everything looks good. I want to make sure that there's no damage to the casing of the unit itself. Going to come to the top hook portion, make sure it rotates freely. Make sure our carabiner has the proper markings. It does. Make sure there's no visual defect, no damage, no modification. And I want to make sure it moves freely. It's very important that we understand that this move at basic fingertip type pressure. When they're in the air, there shouldn't be any fighting to maneuver this. We want to make sure basically as smooth as butter. From the top, I'm now going to work my way down to the bottom here. I'm going to check the bottom hook. Again, make sure that there's no defects. Make sure everything is looking good. Make sure everything operates freely. Everything is locking and staying in place securely. Make sure I've got the proper identification in place and legible. And again, as we talk about the hooks and how they're manufactured, all of the hooks and attachments are going to be to the current ANSI Z359 standards. And now I'm going to start to look through the webbing portion of the SRL. As you can see, the stitching down here is protected by plastic casing, which is very nice. Don't see any damage, don't feel any damage. Now, this is a 40 footer, and this visual inspection can take some time because you do have to go hand over hand through all 40 feet. And while I'm going to be doing that, I'm going to be checking the braking system on a very regular basis. I'm just going to do a few feet of this to give you the idea, but you do have to go through the 40 feet. You want to plan on this webbing laying on a completely clean surface because you don't want it to pick up any debris and then that debris to attach to the webbing and be pulled back into the unit, which can cause damage to the unit and or the webbing. So just gonna slowly pull this out, running the webbing through my fingers, feeling for, again, damage by UV or chemicals. It is the same color throughout. Wanna make sure that I'm not feeling any weld splatter, any heat damage, looking for cuts, snags, tears. And as I'm doing this, I wanna check the brake. There we go. So I'll just keep going through. And again, I would do that through the entire 40 feet. Now, once I get to the 40 feet and I'm coming back, I'm gonna be checking the brakes again when I wanna make sure I release and it catches. There we go. And after that's complete, I would document it on the report. This would be passed and left in service. Now, for versions of SRLs that are of wire rope, could be a galvanized aircraft cable or even a stainless steel aircraft cable. The inspection is the same. It's going to be hand over hand, checking the brake. You're going to need to make sure you have plenty of space for that wire rope to come out, not get dirty and infiltrated with things that could damage it as it goes back in. You're also going to want to make sure you protect your hands because if you do discover a broken wire and you're letting this wire rope run through your hands, it is going to catch you, it's going to do some damage to your hand. So specifically to the cable version, you just want to wear some hand protection, make sure you don't hurt yourself. On this particular SRL, I am noticing some pretty decent corrosion. I'm noticing that this doesn't move freely anymore. I'm going to come down to the bottom hook. And immediately I'm seeing that this isn't functioning properly. It's not closing properly, holding itself in place. Noticing a serious amount of corrosion again. I'm having trouble reading the identification markings on this particular hook. Looking at the webbing, gonna notice that the webbing is extremely dirty. This would typically be probably a bright yellow. You can see how soiled it is. Seeing a little bit of wear and tear, a lot of abrasion, but I do want to check the braking. So where I'm at right now, with the amount of cumulative damage that I'm seeing with this SRL, the corrosion, the lack of this top attachment not moving freely, this hook not moving freely, and just the wear and tear on the webbing, and then understanding persons depending on this, I would reject this and fail it from inspection and document it as such on a periodic inspection. On this particular SRL, as I've looked it over, I'm gonna notice that somebody took a carabiner, made a nice little modification where they put a wire across here. The carabiner does not move freely, actually open at all. Considerable amount of corrosion. Down here, considerable amount of corrosion, even though the hook does seem to be operating. But then getting to the webbing, yeah, the braking system isn't even working on this one. And then the webbing is highly worn, definitely discolored, and just those few items, just this modification right here would have been a failure and removed from service. Now we're gonna walk you through the visual inspection of a lanyard. This is a brand new lanyard, so I'm gonna be able to provide an explanation of what would be an initial inspection, a frequent inspection, and a periodic inspection. So this just arrived at my facility and I'm getting ready to assign it to the individual I ordered it for. So I'm gonna wanna make sure that it is what I needed and everything is in proper order. Documentation from the manufacturer, gonna list the model number, the size, the date of manufacture, gonna wanna keep these records. First thing I'm gonna come to, make sure that the identification from the manufacturer is in place and legible. We can see the manufacturer, the model number, the size, the date. Everything is in place and legible and traceable back to the manufacturer. Gonna wanna make sure my hooks are operational. Proper identification is on each hook. Looking good. Make sure I don't see any issues with my stitching. Now, when we get into the hand over hand for lanyards, this is where you wanna be very particular and very slow. Some of these really compress into, I guess, an accordion type look. You wanna make sure you're trying to feel into all of these little spaces, because if heat damage occurred, a piece of weld splatter flew in there, a metal shaving from a machine shop, and that thing is just working itself through, you don't see it. This could be covered in a little bit of dirt. A lot of reasons you wanna make sure you're doing this hand over hand, feeling for any issues. So these lanyards do take a little bit more time because you do wanna be as thorough as possible as you're trying to work yourself through this. And obviously you're looking for the same other things. You make sure that the lanyard wasn't used in the fall because this thing would be blown apart. It would be quite obvious. But make sure that there's no punctures, no heat damage, no UV damage, no chemical damage, no cuts, tears, weld splatter, all of the basic things we've been walking through. Making sure, again, all of your stitching is nice and tight. You can see that tiny little piece of webbing that they just snipped off at the end. That is not a problem. Everything is moving freely. So for your frequent, this would be approved. For the periodic, it would be documented as a passed. Move on to the next piece. All right, now we're gonna walk you through the visual inspection of a well-used lanyard. First thing I'm noticing is this is a little sticky, quite a bit of corrosion going on. The wear guard for the nylon is looking good, but the webbing itself is looking a little faded. And here I'm gonna look at the stitching. I am noticing some pretty decent abrasion against this stitching. little bit of abrasion right here on the edge of this. Somebody tied it in a knot for some reason. Never do that. It does decrease the strength of the webbing itself. You can feel some abrasion right here, some raised abrasion. Again, coming down, even more abrasion against the stitching of this item. And again, gonna check the hook. This hook won't even open. So with that hook not even opening, that would be an immediate fail, but I would have also had failed it for the abrasion and the total abrasion across the entire lanyard itself. So basically, whether I started with this hook, that would have been a first item failure, or I would have failed it regardless of this hook being good, I would have failed it for the abrasion. Again, we have two more well-used lanyards here. Just want to point out a couple issues here. Both lanyards are suffering severe amounts of abrasion as you work through it. This webbing is starting to show some sort of fading, some sort of UV or chemical damage, but the webbing is still pliable. As we come over to this webbing, you can see much more fading, possible UV damage, chemical damage, but the webbing itself has actually become, I'm gonna say, nearly brittle. So again, that's gonna be evidence across both of these as a loss of strength and would result as enough failure criteria to pull them from service.
Remember, you are responsible for your own safety. You need to inspect your own SRL and your own lanyard before you use them. If you see anything you think is questionable, don't use it. When in doubt, pull it out, get it looked at by a competent person, or replace it. And remember to always follow the manufacturer's recommendations. I hope after watching this video, you have a clear understanding of how to inspect your SRLs and lanyards. And you now know exactly what the removal criteria looks like. If you found this video useful, informative, entertaining, or you just feel like being friendly, then hit that like button so we can get this information out to everyone who needs it. Subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss a video. If you have a question, drop it in the comments so we can get you an answer. My name is Ben, and I'll see you in the next one.